going? Today I'm going to be doing another one of those Sims 4 puzzle build like word challenges that I've been doing on my channel. And this time we are going to be doing cottage. I'm going to be taking the word cottage, rearranging the letters, and building some kind of cottage core home using the new Sims 4 cottage living pack. I'm so excited to finally use it. We're going to get into the video. If you guys like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm always putting out these fun Sims 4 building challenges on my YouTube channel. And yeah, let's get into it. So here is the shell with the letters. I'm gonna rearrange all of these letters and try and build a cottage with this shell. So looking at these letters, I'm kind of picturing the G as like a hedge maze. Like I could change the walls into a fence and go like with these. And then the G can be kind of a maze. So that's gonna be on the bottom floor. By the way, I am building in the new Henford on Bagley world, which is so beautiful, by the way. It's so green and like lush. I think I'm gonna connect the T maybe to the G somehow. We'll leave that little diagonal space, and then I'm kind of envisioning the E like stuck right on in there. And then that'll be the bottom floor and my base. I kind of think the letters in this challenge are gonna work out as the interior too, because if I'm going for a cottage, maybe I'm going for like an older style of cottage, and with that I can get away with more of a closed concept sort of thing. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it at 3 letters for the bottom, so that's my bottom floor right there. I could realistically probably get my entry right in there. Like the hedge maze can be the entrance. Maybe, we'll see. Maybe a side entrance to like the garden. So I'm gonna put the C right above the G because I feel like that just makes the most sense. There's gonna be only that little extra bit like popping out, but I can delete the ceiling because I don't really need that. The T is gonna go right on top of the other T. Just gonna keep it simple. And then I can either put the O or the A on top of the E. I think I'm gonna go with the O. We're gonna have those awkward little like diagonal things in there, but it's fine. We're gonna try and work around it. How is this looking so far? This is weird. I'm gonna have to like hang this above that with like columns or something. And then finally we're left with the A, which I think I'm gonna put on top. And then I could do some kind of like roofing up there. Like maybe if I rotate it, it could work. Just kind of stick that on there. I'll go with that for now. We're gonna leave the A. I'm probably gonna have to rotate that around or something, but let's leave it for now. So this is the shell stacked with letters, 3 floors, and a hedge maze. So now we're gonna roof this thing. This is like the second part of the challenge. Honestly, this is the hardest part of the exterior, in my opinion. I'm wondering if it would be weird if I put a big octagonal roof piece right over the C. I feel like in the back, I could do like a double roof piece like this, and I might have to pull that all the way to the front too. May as well just like copy and paste another piece and like pull it over top here. We've got the A covered, so I'm gonna use another gabled roof piece and then turn it and maybe roof this and connect it over to that. If I could connect that to that point, that would be awesome. That's pretty satisfying. And then I can go in and maybe put like a point on there or something, just cover up that extra little piece. But I think that's pretty good. That's not bad. Then I've got this little area down here, which maybe I could do a patio with. There are so many roofing pieces on this. Oh my gosh, this is a challenge. Okay, I have my work cut out for me here for sure. So this is gonna be a little balcony, this like extra spot. I'm gonna put on my Sims 4 cottage living filter here and pretty much just use the most of that that I can. I found this pack has a lot of exterior. I had a lot of fun on stream testing it out, and I came to the opinion that the exterior items are better for me, in my opinion. Hot take. What if we did a little bit of green roofing with this? Okay, let's get the columns. Hold up the C over here. So I think I'm gonna go with like a green and that beige color for my color scheme. So just gonna put these on the corners. I'm definitely adding some trim to get rid of that weird like white space. I think I'm gonna use Island Living like roof trim on there. So in here, so that I can actually get like an entryway through the maze, I'm gonna have to get a little cheeky. I'm gonna have to go and create a wall. I'm gonna put 2 columns on the sides and then turn this into a spandrel. There we go. So now you can actually get through there. I'm just gonna put a small side door. This can be like just entryway to the garden, which will go like this way eventually. I've done my wallpaper, but I feel like I'm on a really big lot. This pack came with a 64 by 64, which is really awesome, but I don't really want to build on here today. I'm gonna move. There we go. This lot is slightly smaller. It's like a 50 by 40. Good enough. And I think the lighting is a lot better. Okay, so my wallpaper is done. Let's go in and do the windows, which we have so many window options. I was kind of blown away when I saw how many. Like, look at all of these. I feel like it's a pretty decent variety too. Like, I was blown away. Like I said, I feel like the exterior in this pack is like way better than the interior, but I don't know if that's like a popular opinion that's going around, but whatever. Ooh, actually, before I forget, I wasn't gonna go into the roofing details yet, but I do wanna use these. This is my new favorite thing. Like, I'm gonna be using these a lot. These like roof details that I saw in the trailer and I was like, how the heck did you get this on there? We're definitely gonna get some bunnies up there. Look how cute. Couple chimneys. Okay, now I'm gonna go back. Here we are with the terrain paint. I've done most of the windows, I think, and now I'm gonna go in and add the final details, which is so awesome because we got so many new vines. I'm gonna be using those a lot. I'm also gonna be trying to like connect these awkward parts here with these new, what are these? Braggers. And look at all the new vine options. There's so many. This made me so happy. We can also use some of these overhangs on the side, which look really good. I wanna use one of these things. This is from Get Together. I'm gonna put that right on top of that awkward little point. Okay, detailing is pretty much done. I'm gonna go in and do the landscaping and then we're gonna go inside. But the landscaping is gonna be a huge part of this because there's so much exterior stuff to go out here. Like, I wanna do the whole farm. I wanna add some animals. Like, look how big these coops are and I wanna have a few of them. So I'm gonna do maybe along this side. We can do the animals and then on the other side we can do like farm stuff. I do want to use this archway somewhere. Oh my god, this is gonna be so pretty. I'm so excited. We'll use some fencing to separate like the cows and the chickens and stuff, I think. Or should I keep them all in one area? Maybe they want to be friends. I was actually pretty shocked that we have three fencing options for this. Oh, and I got this really cool tree. Look at this in the nighttime. It's so beautiful. Of course we're gonna need a pond, so I think I'm gonna do a pond right here. If you guys thought I did a lot of ponds in my builds before, you wait. I am at quite a few animals in here. I've got three chicken coops, two of the cow things, and like a bunch of the bunny and like bird things. When these builds come to life in live mode and you see the bunnies hopping around, it is like pure happiness. Get Together has some really cute things that go with this pack too. Like, we've got this there that comes with Get Together, like the home farmer starter kits. There's also another wheelbarrow. We do get one with cottage living, but if I like didn't want to repeat them, I could use the other one. Also, side note, I've turned on debug and I realized this in the last stream. There are so many plants hidden in here and like so many goodies, like this tractor I can add. It's a little big, which I don't really know why they didn't include this in the game. Like, there's so many cute items in debug. So this is what I ended up with for my exterior. This is the outside of it. With all of the landscaping done and everything, my little animal area is over here. We've got the chicken coops and the cow area and like all this cute stuff. In the back, we've got a picnic table with a picnic basket, actually two picnic baskets, and my farm area over here, which used quite a bit of debug with like the tractor and like whatever the heck this is. But yeah, this is my farm area. This is what the cottage core shell ended up looking like. We're gonna go inside. I've started to try and figure out the layout of this thing. So we're gonna walk in here. This is our front entry area. I have my stairs here. I'm thinking like around maybe the T or the E, we'll have the kitchen and the dining room. And maybe somewhere around here, we'll have like a bathroom. We'll see. Upstairs, we're gonna have the living room right there. We're gonna have a hallway, another bathroom, and potentially a kid's room over here with a kid's bathroom there. And then upstairs, I'm gonna do an attic bedroom. My lighting is a little weird in this. Like, some of the letters kind of look greenish and like very different from the other ones. I don't really know why that has happened. But yeah, that's kind of weirding me out a little bit. We'll work around it though. We'll see how it goes. I also have to say, I love the wallpapers. We've got this floral swatch. We also have this little bunny one, which is perfect for a kid's room. So I'm gonna start here with my kitchen. I think I'm gonna have my kitchen going along this wall here and maybe wrapping around the side so that I cover up that hedge. We got two new fridges. I don't know which one I like better, honestly. I do love this retro one, but having that wooden style is so different from the other ones. Let's try the retro one. So I'm gonna get some counters. A lot of people are saying that these look very similar to the country kitchen kit, which I definitely have to agree with. There's like subtle differences. There's like the flap, which gives it away a lot. I feel like we've got a lot of kitchen stuff lately. We've got Dream Home Decorator came with like so many new kitchen options. We had the country kitchen kit not too long ago. I feel like we're due for like a bathroom kit or something. Ooh, I really like this corner piece here though. That's pretty with that hanging plant. So big kitchen wrapping all the way around there. That clutter looks so cute. I kind of want to incorporate that like pink. That would be pretty bold. I think my oven is gonna go over on this side. So we have this old like oven here. Look how retro that is. I don't think I've ever seen one of those in real life. And then I'm gonna go in with one of these. Let's do the green and pink. I'm very down for that. And we have a new oven hood. Thank goodness. I have been complaining about these for so long. If you've watched my videos for a long time, you know I hate the oven hoods in The Sims 4, but we finally got a new one. And we need a sink, which I'm probably gonna put Maybe like right here?
That looks so cute. Okay, yeah, let's clutter. I need a trash can. Trash can is gonna go just kind of like right at the end there. I hope you guys can't hear. There's literally construction going on right out my window and it's driving me insane. So if you can hear that, I really apologize. Look at that little tea set. Like, come on. I think I'm also gonna put in some country kitchen clutter. So like over on this side, I can probably put some of these. Actually, maybe I'll leave that counter for prep. So everything else, all of the clutter is on there. This is very cute. I was surprised too to see how many color options there are with this pack. Outside is very neutral, like the brick swatches and the roofing paint swatches and stuff like that are very neutral. But once you come in, the swatches do get more colorful, which makes me happy. Down at the end, I'm gonna put a table here. This is where I can put maybe some more kitchen clutter. So I know we got this new shelf with a cutting board. I'm gonna put that over here. Any of the like country kitchen stuff that I didn't get to add, like I think there's a tea set. Yeah, a teapot that I didn't get to use. And there we go. There's my kitchen. I think it looks adorable. I want to put my dining table, I guess, like down the center there. And then this area can be more storage or something. I know there's a cute shelf I could put, like this one that hangs some extra herbs, and there's a purse on there. Perfect. All right, so I got some hanging plants. We've got our little shelf. I put a broom here from Laundry Day, which by the way, Laundry Day also goes really well with this pack. And this is our kitchen area. This is the tea done. And for my dining table, I'm gonna use this small little circle one, which I'm very happy that we got. I love these little dining tables that don't take a lot of room. Let's do a cats and dogs rug in there and maybe just put some stuff on the wall. This wallpaper is like, you don't really have to go too crazy with your wall decor. So I'm gonna put a feather plant from Dream Home Decorator. I could probably get a hutch in here somewhere. Oh, we got one. I haven't seen this yet. Okay, so we got a hutch. Let's stick that in there. God, I hate this lighting. Okay, so there is my dining room. I'm gonna do a walk-in area, probably just, maybe we could do this eco lifestyle, like shelf, this new plant, which I'm absolutely in love with from Cottage Living. And we'll do this big shelf from Laundry Day where I'll just put some clutter in there. Ooh, and maybe this little shelf. Okay, let's go upstairs. We're gonna go up and do the living room right here. Oh my God, I fixed it. I fixed it. Thank goodness. There we go. I got my lighting back. Okay, here we go. This is the hallway. That is so much better. It was the flooring of the O. That ruined everything. All right, I'm just gonna leave that. Wait, let's do like a little secret room. So I can't wrap that around anymore, but I'm gonna barrier this off and I'm gonna do a secret reading room. I mean, old houses are weird. Hi, so for some reason, my camera decided not to show you the cute reading room, even though it was super adorable and very private. My camera said no. So we are moving on upstairs to the living room. Thank you. Fireplace can go right on this wall here. And then I can do my living room here. That's kind of perfect. This could be bookshelf wall. So let's do maybe just a couple side by side going down that way. And then our couch area won't be too squishy. I can put my couch there. And then our chairs can go kind of on a diagonal like that. For my lighting, I'm gonna use that cute pink base game lamp. And then I do wanna put an end table. We did get a cute new bookshelf. So even though I already have mine over there, I'm gonna just raise this up. And then over here, I do have a little extra space. Maybe I could put like a kid's play area right here. Or we do a desk and then the kid's play area can be over there. I think I'm gonna do that instead. Maybe we shouldn't play by the stairs. Very cute. Okay, so we're gonna move on. This is our living room area. I'm in love. I really, really love that wallpaper so much. Let's do the bathroom next. So I was a little disappointed that we didn't get any new bathroom stuff. Like we got a bathtub, but I feel like it's very similar to base game. Like we got this one, which I'm pretty sure we have this bathtub already, just like in a different swatch or like something very similar to this. I'm gonna also use the new sink over here and obviously no new toilet. But like I said, I wouldn't mind getting a bathroom kit sometime soon with like bathroom clutter and just some like cute new stuff. I feel like we're due. So there is our bathroom complete. We're gonna do, let's do this hallway. Do I wanna bring this all the way through? I feel like it's too much to continue. Like I can't just keep doing that. Maybe I'll do, we'll get the brick again. Yeah, and then over here will be kids' play area. I feel like I have to put the chicken tent. The chicken tent was the first hint that we had for farming. I gotta do it. That'll go over there. Maybe we do cardboard dollhouse. I never realized how cute that could look in a kid's room with like the chicken on it. That's from the country kitchen kit. I can put some little dolls on there. Aw. So our kids area is done. I like it with the shelf over here. I think that's my favorite part. We're gonna move on and do the kids bedroom, which is very big. This is a very big kids bedroom. I do wish we got a single bed. Cottage Living only comes with this one bed, which I'm gonna put in the attic bedroom. Ooh, that actually fits pretty good. A single bed would have have been real nice. Like, just even the same kind of thing. Ooh, Season's bed looks really pretty in here with that wallpaper. I'm gonna use one of those. I think I wanna do two beds in here. And maybe that one over on the side. We can do our dresser in the middle there, and let's do Blarfy. Oh, this is Bun. Who the heck is Blarfy? This is Blarfy, my bad. Oh, we can have a little creativity desk over here. Maybe a TV corner for them. These kids are lucky. This is definitely like a really successful farmer's house. Maybe they live with their grandkids. Either way, it's so cute. I love like the animal themed bedroom. There's so many toys for these kids. Okay, I think I'm gonna cool it on the toys. Oh, the gnome guy. Okay, he's gotta be here. The gnome riding a chicken. There it is. We're gonna do the final bathroom, then go upstairs and do the attic bedroom finally, and we'll be done. Oh, we need the elephant shower for an animal themed bedroom for the kids. Definitely gonna need that. And I think I'm gonna make this one a little bit more cluttered. So I'll put this stuff on the floor, maybe by the toilet. Cute. I don't really ever do kids' bathrooms, to be honest. But I kind of like this. Okay, there's our kids' bathroom done. We're gonna move on upstairs to the attic bedroom, which is gonna be the final one. Look how big this house is. Oh my goodness. All right, so I already have my bed. I'm gonna try and match which swatch for wallpaper I want to my bed. I love that. All right, hold on. It's a very colorful cottage. Okay, I'm gonna try this. See if I can get away with this. That's some brick wallpaper for my attic. Or should I do wood? Yeah, I think I'm gonna try that. Just some like base game wood paneling for the attic. Okay, let's figure this out here. So rug under there, I think I wanna do a TV mounted above the bed. I might use the other fireplace in here actually. So TV there, let's do, yeah, fireplace in like one of these corners. So I did, oh God, that is huge. I didn't use this one, but I'm gonna use that in my attic bedroom, I guess. I can maybe fit like one chair in the back. There we go, that's quite the fire hazard. Just be careful if you download this. We also got a new like vanity kind of. I really wanna use that. So I'm gonna use outdoor retreat mirror. Okay, so far so good. And then yeah, I wanna use the new vanity that we got for cottage living and anything else that I wanna put in this house that I haven't used yet. Oh, like the little crochet thing. We should do a crochet area. That's maybe what this can be. I gotta get an end table and then I can put my crochet stuff there. Perfect. Yeah, crochet area can be that back fireplace. That makes sense. And then that's gonna be the vanity corner. So I do wanna put a chair right next to it, even though they're not really gonna be using it. I can do a chair right there. I'm putting the mushroom chair in that awkward little spot. This bedroom is huge. What the heck else should I put in here? A knitting area maybe? I could see them knitting maybe if they like to crochet. We could do a couple rocking chairs. I'm loving that it's kind of a mess in here. Like there's a lot going on. We've got our knitting area over there. And yeah, there's just like a lot to do at this house in general, I feel like. So this is our attic bedroom. This was our final result of our cottage house. I hope you guys like this challenge. I've been waiting to do this for a while. I'm gonna put this on the gallery under Sydney Macrotta if you wanna download it. And yeah, that's all I got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.